How to attract money using the law of attraction. How to attract money into your life using the law of attraction. Siguro by now, you already know or heard about the law of attraction. Pero kung hindi pa, I suggest na basahin ninyo ang librong The Secret o panoorin nito. Meron yan sa YouTube. Basically, ang sinasabi lang nito is that what you think about and feel strongly about will bring more into your life. Nagmumula ito sa paniniwalang like attracts like. Kapag pinagsama mo ang positive statement or positive affirmation with a positive emotion, you will attract positive experiences and opportunities leading to those things that you want to manifest. If you want to try this law, you have to raise the vibrational frequency of the thought and feeling to attract what you want. Beautiful people, ako po si Miss P, Princess Javier Castro, creating videos to help you live a great life filled with happiness, love, and success. Kung bago ka sa channel na ito, please consider subscribing. Pindutin mo na rin yung all para updated ka sa lahat ng mga videos na ina-upload ko. There are actually three basic steps to attract what you want. Ask, believe, and receive. How to attract money using the law of attraction. First step is to ask for what you want. If you want money, specify exactly how much money do you really want and why you want it and how would you feel as a result of having it. Once decided, isulat ito. Write it down. Stick it out to places kung saan madali mo ito makita. Pwede sa ref, sa wallet mo, sa mirror o sa lamin. Ilagay sa mga lugar na napakadaling mapansin. Second step is to believe that you can have that thing that you want. You can choose to believe whatever you want. It's a choice. Ask yourself, why do I believe that I can get this amount of money? The problem with beliefs is that there are beliefs that are rooted in your subconscious mind and that no longer appears to be a belief but appears to be true to you. These are your limiting beliefs. You got them or adapt them from childhood. Diba nga, your values are formed at 7 years old. False beliefs about money are like, rich people are bad. You become less spiritual when you have money. You have to work hard for money. Wanting to have more money is greedy and greed is bad. Money doesn't grow in trees. You have to have more money to make more of it. People like us never get rich. Bilang lang ang pwedeng yumaman. Maraming mga mayayaman, malungkot ang buhay, at marami pang mga ibang mga false beliefs. Marami din ang mga beliefs that you formed and forgotten that you were the ones who made them up and decided that they are true. Siguro while growing up, your mother is always out making money. You decided that you'd rather to be happy and raise happy children than being wealthy. Maybe your parents fight about money all the time. You decided that money creates conflict. O kaya naman, your father worked enough but never gets ahead. So you decided that no matter how hard you work, it doesn't matter. Pursuing wealth is senseless. There are also many other limiting beliefs that block your manifestation. Example, I don't deserve to be happy. I'm not good enough. I'm not as charismatic as my brother or my sister. I'm not fit for wealth. I don't deserve to be successful. How do you correct your limiting beliefs that hamper you to have an abundant life? Replace them with new beliefs through positive affirmations. There are two types of positive affirmation. Affirmations that amplify more positive affirmations. Example, money flows to me easily and effortlessly. I'm a money magnet. It's easy to manifest large amounts of money. The more money I have, the more spiritual I become. I deserve to be wealthy. I am open and receptive to all the wealth and abundance life offers me. My wealth gives me the ability to be of great service to others. The other kind of affirmation amplifies your belief as if the money that you want is already yours. Example, I'm so happy and grateful that we sold our home at a certain amount. You can state an amount that you like. I'm so happy and grateful that I landed my dream job with. You can be specific. State the company that you would like to be working with. I'm happy and grateful that my income is constantly increasing. Repeat your affirmation at least twice a day, one in the morning or one in the evening. If you can make it three times a day, like putting another one during the day, that works too. Another way to change your beliefs is by reading books on wealth building, biography of people who has built wealth and success. Read books on the law of attraction. Books that I can recommend are books by Louise Hay, Wayne Dyer, Joe Dispenza, Miriam Williamson, Neville Goddard, to name a few. You can also try what Abraham Hicks suggests. Keep a large amount of money in your pocket. Ang suggestion niya, $100. For us Filipinos, pwedeng 1,000 pesos or maybe if you have more than that, say 3,000, mas okay. That is kung meron lang. You can go around some places, malls, and pretend you're buying those things that you like using the money in your wallet. Remember, pretend lang, do not buy. This will increase your feeling of abundance. The key is not to spend, and if you really need to, replace it right away. The last phase in the law of attraction is to receive. In this phase, you have to do everything you can to raise your vibration, and that is your emotional vibration. Focus more on love, joy, forgiveness, and gratitude. These emotions are in high vibration. Remember, what you focus on expands. When you adapt the mindset of being always grateful, more of that sort will come to you. You will experience more things that you can be grateful for. The thing is, most of us, na-program tayo sa ating pagtanda na nakatingin sa kung anong wala, imbes na sa kung anong meron. To focus on what is not working instead of what is working. To adapt a gratitude mindset, write at least three things na pwede mo mapagpasalamatan na nangyari during the day. Whatever it is that you can be thankful for, write them all down. Start with just three things before you sleep until you form a habit. Ang dami niyan actually. Thank you for the water that you drink. Thank you for the electricity. Thank you for good health. Thank you for a roof over your head. Thank you for your pet. Isulat mo, tatlo lang, every night. Do not write this in your mind. Isulat mo talaga sa papel. Mas intense ang focus when you write it down. One thing that lowers your vibration is when you're carrying a grudge, being resentful and judgmental towards others. Importante ang magpatawad at mag-move on. I remember Dr. Wayne Dyer as he was writing the book Wishes Fulfilled. He was trying to manifest something and he's having a hard time. He discovered that there was this one person that he hasn't fully forgiven, and the moment he released that resentment towards this person, dumating ang kanyang manifestation. Remember, lahat ng mga tao, including you and me, we always do the best we can. Ginagawa natin ang alam nating tama sa mga panahon na yon. When you forgive, hindi ibig sabihin na bumibigay ka sa kanyang mga ginawa. You are just letting go of the negative emotion inside us towards them. Start doing things that gives you joy. If you love painting, start doing that. If you love dancing or singing, take time doing that during the day. If you love cooking or chatting with friends and that gives you joy and happiness, make way to do that. Listening to good or uplifting music or playing sports, if that gives joy to you, do that too. Meditation is also one way to raise your vibration. It stops the momentum of not feeling good. When you meditate, especially in the morning, you are setting the tone for the entire day. Remember, your emotion is the best indication of knowing where your vibration is. Your emotion, whatever you might want to call it, frustration, anger, fear, love, joy, happiness, whatever it may be, there are only two types, good and bad emotions. When you feel good, you are in high vibration. When you feel bad, you are in low vibration. So always find a way of feeling good. I hope you find this video helpful, and if you do, please give me a thumbs up. I-share mo na rin sa mga friends and loved ones mo, the people that you care about, so that like you, they too can live a great life. I'll see you next time!